Tiriti led is quite scary for a number of organisations, particularly those that are not government. There is a narrative that if you are not a government agency or a government department, then you don't have a Tiriti obligation. But Te Tiriti created an opportunity for all peoples to settle and make Aotearoa their home. And therefore, if you are in Aotearoa, you are tangata Tiriti. You are here because the Tiriti permits you to do that.
Being a Te Reo organisation to Foundation North means behaving and acting in a way which is consistent with the commitment to Te Reo. Some of the people who have been involved in Foundation North's journey, and this goes back to Mātua Kevin Prime, who was our first Kaumātua. He also was chair of Foundation North. He probably was the person who broke the ice for the journey and got us underway.
Tēnā rākoutou katoa, ko tōku ingoa, ko Kevin Prime. I heke mai au ngā kāwe I rangatira o Ngāti Hine. Ko takutai Ngātū te tuatahi ki taua tari, e kati ana te kuaha. Kuhua tau ki roto, ki te au e turituri ana te whare ngā tāngata e inuti ana, ka hore tāngata I anga mai ke au. Ki te anau ko hanga neke neke haere ko tino rere ki kia mohe koe, ko ke atu te rua te kautau I aine, mai taku urunga te ki runga tau e tēnei rōpū. Ko tā koe ki te akena I aine, ko te rere ke tanga o te āhua te whakahaere I roto I tēnei rōpū o te kaitiaki pūtea mō Tāmaki mō Taitokerau. I te mea mehe mea he tikanga Māori kei mua I te whānau, te rōpū nei. E aka tutukia nei ai nei, mehe mea taima e nei kaimahi hau, nā ko pōwhiritia tēnā kaimahi ki roto I te ōpū. Ko ena mahi e mahi katoa nei ai nei, hore ka uraruaru. Nā ko ena mahi katoa e mahi anei ai nei.
One of the things about the state of play 20 years ago, which that's roughly where we were, is that the ordinary reflexes of Pākehā around working within Māori context weren't nearly as refined as they are now. So the degree of anxiety people would feel going into a Pākehā, Māori context would be quite high, quite highly charged sometimes. And then one of the things that Kevin was particularly good at was diffusing that, to actually pay attention to the relationships and to provide tikanga knowledge at the point where it was pretty important to do so.
Timata atu ko ngā hui hui ngā kato ka hakapuarea tau ki te inui, nā ki te karakia, mehe mea tangata hau ana ko tai mai, ko tū au ki te whakamihia tika rātou, ka mihi ki o rātou whānau, wena mahi katoa whakauru mai au ki roto.
And of course he had the clues around how you advance the conversations in New Zealand about the question of what responsibilities Te Tiriti brings to organisations such as these charitable trusts.
Kia ora ko ngā tāngata pēnā I a Pat Snedden, ko rātou ngā iwi tino kaha ki te tautoko I ngā kaupapa Māori. Ko ia e nui no atu tā rātou whakatutuki tā rātou peipei ngā mahi Māori nei ki roto I te pōri, te roto I te pōri ki au. Nā reira mea kanau e nā rātou nei, tā nā tā rātou kahai, haere iwe nei kaupapa Māori I roto I te pōri.
Some of this conversation was very confrontational because it was moving, if you like, an audience who thought everything was mostly all right to a position where actually we've got a problem and now we're going to do something about it.
Nā koe anō ki aura, ko te mea nui tainatū tātū te whakatakoto he kaupapa, tainatū tātū I te whakaatū mai e aha te huarai me pēha ko te hakatutukui, engari ko te mea nui hoki kia mahi a te mahi, hei aha te kōrero, kia tutukui rāno te mahi kātahi nō kia ea tō noho I runga I te ao nei.
I think this was 2006, and we had gone out to Long Bay to actually reflect on what we were doing as board members. And there was just simply a break in the whole activity. And I went for a walk on the beach by myself. And as I was walking along, I thought to myself, well, what's going on here? What would happen if we engaged the communities we normally fund at arm's length in essentially a partnership arrangement, whereby we collectively made decisions about what we could do with this to advance the opportunity set for Māori and Pacific.
E hui hui ngata tā mātou I waho, nā ka haere atu o peti te taha moana hoki mai ke kona anu te tai whakaaro tōna moe moe I haka atu mai ki a mātou.
By the end of the day, they said yes to it, which was highly surprising and quite lovely. The outcome of the story of the beach is the Māori and Pacific Educational Initiative. One of the most important aspects of that was it was demonstrating an organisation prepared to do what it says it would do. In other words, prepared to go down the route of examining what the Te Tiriti relationships required of us and then taking action to actually implement that. Not to declare at the first instance the amount of pūtea available, because that would simply focus everybody's attention on just the money. We wanted people focused at the whanangatanga end of it, the relationship end of it, and at the kaupapa end of it, the vision of what they were trying to achieve. And that worked.
So Article 3 of both Te Tiriti and the Treaty purport to allow people to have equitable outcomes and have equality. But we weren't seeing that in our funding decisions, so it wasn't embedded in our policies, it wasn't embedded in our practices, so it was something that we had to embed. We were very fortunate, both Whae Moe and I, to be able to leverage off work that had been done prior to our arrival, particularly around the Māori Pacifica Education Initiative, which ring-fenced funding for education outcomes for Māori and Pacifica, and the rationale for that was around equitable outcomes in education. So there was a nattering, there was a slight understanding of the importance of that direction, but it was ring-fenced to that space. And so Whae Moe and I had a job to elevate that outside of that specific fund allocation into everything that we did. And so the strategy became to embed a Tiriti statement within the Foundation North strategy. So that required some baby steps. So our first step then was to get a Māori strategy. So we had to work with people and work with our board, work with our staff to get that through. It was a negotiated outcome. Our aspirations that we wanted to see to drive outcomes for our community were negotiated. It wasn't everything that we asked for, but it was good enough.
Yeah, I guess I have to acknowledge the work that had been done well before my time to create the platform. And when I say that, I'm referring to the Māori strategy. And that is really what drew me to Foundation North in the first place. And the Māori strategy at the time spoke of enabling Māori aspirations. It spoke to and acknowledged the importance of mātauranga Māori, and it spoke to, in a gentle way, a commitment to Te Tiriti o Waitangi. So that's what drew me in to Foundation North. I realised that the organisation had amazing intention, and in its infancy, courageous words and strategies, and a desire to put action to those words.
Yeah, I wouldn't say that equity was embedded in our practices at Foundation North at the time I arrived. Really had to elevate my voice in that space. One of the applications that came through was from Manurewa Marae, and it was a really profound application. And what they recognised is that they could bring all parts of the community into Manurewa Marae and wrap around services if they could attract their kids to the marae. And the way that they could attract kids to the marae was through kapahaka. When Manurewa Marae came to pitch for the funding, one of my fellow trustees said to her, "So how does running around in a grass skirt get you a job?" And had no knowledge or no understanding that that was a racist and offensive comment. So I whisked him off in the break and explained why that was racist and offensive. I don't think he accepted it at the time, but we also shifted our processes. So we adopted more of a pōhiri model where you come to engage and you engage with respect. So there is a delineation between a relationship building opportunity and getting down to business opportunity. I made an assumption that in service of all communities, everybody would see that you would look for needs-based outcomes, and that wasn't the case when I arrived. It was the case by the time Whae Moe and I departed from Foundation North.
So the question is, how do you take action against the commitment that you've made to Te Tiriti of Waitangi? And we started with the trust deed, where the governance aspects of Foundation North are heavily dependent on the Trust Act, but also the trust deed that we have. In the Pākehā world, things like trustees and the overall governance documents dictate the way that trustees and governors should operate. It's super important, therefore, those documents reflect your commitment to Te Tiriti Waitangi.
So the step we'd done was start with a Māori strategy to get into the Foundation North overarching strategy. The step that occurred after my time was to embed it in the trust deed, and then it's immovable.
And we have a specific clause, I know it well, clause 6.4, which speaks to the fact that we must consider Te Tiriti of Waitangi when undertaking our activities.
Yeah, it certainly is a learning journey for the trustees, as you would appreciate, having 15 trustees who are representative of the diverse community of Tamaki and Auckland. But what we've found is, while they have legitimate questions about what does it mean, they've all been open to walking into the journey and appreciating the place of Te Tiriti.
What very quickly flowed was a series of actions and commitments that we would have to then undertake, which included things like committing to training, particularly through our Atamai sessions, having somebody on our leadership group, making sure that there was a minimum of three trustees that sat around the governance table who had skills in Te Reo, understanding of Matranga Māori, that we had staff who were engaged at community level, who actually were Māori, so we took those steps to start with. All of those actions are slowly and in a cumulative way making us better at becoming a Te Tiriti-based organisation.
Often we will see a commitment to raising cultural intelligence of staff and people, and I'm 100% supportive of that. I think that's important. What we're beginning to do now, and we're in our infancy, is to look at how do we incorporate other worldviews or Māori worldviews, Māori epistemologies, into the machinery to help us support decision makers to make their decisions.
So we have four very core values to the way that we operate at Foundation North. The first being around teamwork, and in our case, kia kotahi tahoe, paddling in the same direction, particularly our waka, facing forwards, looking to the future. It's the second one for me being around learning, ākor, the concept of reciprocal learning. The third one for us is around doing the right thing. When we first spoke about that, and you'll find in many organisations the concept of excellence, the concept of integrity, of respect. For us, it came down to three things: tika, doing things in the right way; pono, in terms of actually with integrity; and araha, in terms of having love and care and respect for people. And the fourth value, which is probably the most special to me, and I've failed to find this anywhere else in where I've worked or other organisations, is called whakamana. And whakamana for us means that part of our job is to uplift the mana of others, and in doing so, that will reflect well on us.
One of the things you're asking yourself the question is, given the pūtea that you've got under your control, how can you most uplift the community? It's not about yourself. It's about the people you're serving.
Nā ngā kaihautū pērā i a pita nei, ko rātou ngā mea tō ki te whakatutu ki te kaupapa. Mā te poaria nei, whakaatu mai e a te huarahi, me peake te whakakoatu ki te whakauru mai, ngā tikanga Māori nei, ngā kaupapa Māori nei, ki moe te aroro te poaria. Nā, ko ngā tāngata pene i a pita me ngā kaimahi hoki o rātā kautūra ki te mahi e te mahi kōti ki te whāriki mai e te poaria.
As a Pākehā leader in this work, having not had exposure to Te Tiriti of Waitangi when I was growing up, nor Te Reo, it's been quite hard for me to do that journey. And I can recount the first time that I actually had to go in my own pōwhiri, coming on as a chief executive in Whangarei. I actually went into the car park a couple of hours early and spent probably a good hour and a half of that 2 hours just practising my pepeha, and it reminded me how it must have been for Māori coming into the Pākehā world, how uncomfortable that must feel to try and speak and learn a different language. And now I was sitting in that position. So it does feel uncomfortable from time to time, but we committed when I first started that we would lean into that, we would learn, we would understand, and only by having that empathy could we then actually truly become and progress to being Te Tiriti based.
I recall in my early days as the Māori advisor, we used to have a wall calendar of all the events that Foundation North was going to participate. And so one of the events every year is around Te Tiriti o Waitangi. And on this particular wall calendar, it was colour-coded to these are the Pacifica events, these are the ethnic diversity events, these are general events, and then there was a colour for the Māori events. And I noticed that Te Tiriti o Waitangi, what we were going to do on Waitangi Day, was in the colour-coded for a Māori event. And I, with love, sort of said, hey, how come that's a Māori event? It's a all of New Zealander event. You know, Te Tiriti o Waitangi belongs to and is an obligation and responsibility of all people that call Aotearoa home.
Me, although it may have been uncomfortable, it's far more comfortable now. And I do want to thank all of those that have been involved from a Te Māori point of view to welcome Pākehā into this which is their world. There are a number of people who have helped with the Foundation North journey. Each one of them has opened a slightly different door through which we've chosen to walk.
Kaumātua Kevin, people like him who have almost had to carry that hope on behalf of many, and then as each of us are given the opportunity and the privilege to be part of the organisation, it's just incumbent on us to keep that work going.
I suppose if I've got a value today, it's the extent of encouraging people not to panic about this. Far better for us to actually say being intrinsically bicultural is a really important part of our life. That gives us insights which we don't get when we just simply stay in our own quarter. The work that was done at Foundation or AFB Community Trust and then Foundation North around that message was really powerful work. Relax, believe in ourselves, go for the good thing. Don't shrink ourselves in order to pretend we've still got power that we used to have. Enable ourselves to actually embrace a new New Zealand, which is really, really interesting, and we could be much better as a nation about it.
Ka mutuka ki te ake nau, ko neke neke haere I tōku taenga tuatahi, ki hei te tangata I hakatau mai, ki hei mea mai I nau mai, haere mai, ki hei mi I ngā mate, ki hei o ki wena mei ki a tutuki I roto I te poari, e aene mahi ane te poari, e mahi ane ngā kaimahi, e haere tunu na ngā mahi aene.